96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Now y'all know Christmas in the Bahamas. It ain't gonna be the same without the sound of the goat skin drum. So now I want all the kings of Jokuru to take me to Bay Street. Hey, don't give me the little side corner. Take me to Wilson Square. Hey, come on, Ola. Hudson, Jackson, Ness, Barabbas, Sunny Tribe, Sammy Thompson. All y'all come. Come on, Calvin. They coming.
My mic just went dead. Ooh. Can you still hear me? I don't hear anything.
I can hear you.
You still hear me?
I can hear you.
So we still live? I don't even hear myself. Okay, anyway. Good morning and welcome to Guardian Radio AM. No, I still can't hear me, no. No, I know.
Speak.
Okay, Aaron can hear me. I can't hear myself.
Speak again.
Hello?
I can hear you.
You can hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, but
speak
I can't
directly hear. Into the mic.
All right, the mic in my mouth. All has been dropping back to my face.
Yeah? I can hear you.
You can hear me? But that's good. We can start the show despite it, even though I can't hear me. Right? Good day. Today is Thursday, December
14th.
It's a little after 11 o'clock in the morning. Once again, this is C.A. Newry, and I shall be your host for the day. And I have the tech. Yeah, see? I can't hear myself. Okay, I can hear myself now. Yeah. You mean I was live? Yeah. I mean, people can hear me talking all that kind of stuff? No, shouting your ears, too. This is what you do in live radio. Yes. And we are having a discussion. Aaron, actually, continuing the discussion with Aaron, right? She is celebrating.
It's a year-end review.
It's a year-end review, but you're celebrating.
Creatives and influencers, artists, musicians, the creative community. And we're having a conversation about the top influencers of 2023.
I have received 6 texts.
Yeah.
Asking, how come you haven't called my name?
C.A. Newry?
Yes.
Because you don't Bahamians. You don't do it like that. You can't honor yourself. Listen, I know it's very difficult.
I'm reading one now saying that I am a major influencer in the Bahamas. Asking if you follow me on Facebook.
C.A. Wait, let me see the text. I just want to make sure you didn't say it.
No. I have a text for you.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Like, I'm a big shot. It's like, even the politician knows me.
I beg, quote.
I put C.A. Newry on the list.
Yes, you put me
on the list. You on the list. You didn't have to beg.
Can I put you on the list, Aaron?
Pardon?
Can I put you on the list?
I mean, you could. I can't put me on the list, but you could do it.
Yeah, I want to put you on the list.
Why are you putting Aaron on the list?
Because, first of all, I feel like Aaron's history, I don't know if a lot of people know, but the hub and mm-hmm. being able to get people started.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like the hub paid so many ways for new open mics to come and for me to be able to do that as well. And also at the same time with the programming here at the show, you include a lot of creatives and artists here and you invite us on. So mm-hmm. I want to put you on the list.
So Aaron is on the list.
I run people hard.
I find
I
find that when I'm with Aaron, people accost us and say, hey, you're Aaron Green. And I'm standing there and say, okay, you have no clue who I am. Oh, that's a guy who's beyond with you on the Aaron Green show. I said, but I have my own show. But that's okay. I celebrate that too. I like being incognito. Right? But today, we are celebrating creatives. Erin is doing her year-end review. I'm joining Erin. I'm putting it that way. I'm joining Erin on her year-end review. And because this conversation titillated me to the point where I'm sitting back and listening, especially having Tanisha Pratt in-house, right, who is an established poet. I dare to say a regionally renowned poet, because if she is publishing Pui, because I've been trying to get in Pui for decades, and they keep on rejecting me. That's a big magazine to be published in. Mm-hmm. And the only person I know was Manuato, Manu Raming.
Asha.
Yeah.
Asha Raming, yeah.
And Obadiah Smith, mm-hmm. and Christian Campbell was the only ones I knew in my head to who was published in that magazine. And to know that Tanisha Pratt is now included in that is something I can humble myself and say, man, no, she's real.
That's important. A big deal.
And then to know that she went to school to specialize in this. I haven't come across any Bohemian poet who went to school to learn poetry as a job.
And it's we say thank you to the poet for doing that, right? Because you don't need university to write a poem, but you use university to hone your skills, mm-hmm. to engage with other creatives, to be a part of that creative fire. It's a beautiful process, but it also legitimizes the work that you do. Because I can tell you, Mr. Newry, she got one line from one poem called No Brackets on My Tongue that says, why you want me speak like your queen when I have my own monarchy? That's a whole thesis. Mm-hmm. It's a whole thesis, right? The university sort of legitimizes the raw work that comes from the poet. It is awesome. So
let me start.
Yeah.
What is this creative by definition? What is my senior audience, old school, who are old school, who is listening and saying, but what Aaron and Cecil and now Ms. Pratt talking about, and why are you giving these youngsters this recognition? So we need to start off from there so everyone can participate and say, okay, I see where you're going. What is a creative?
All right, so arts and culture is the term that we normally use to capture all of the people that create things like music, like literature, poems, prose, fiction, nonfiction, right? Arts and culture, the musicians, the people who sing, the people who write music and compose music, and the people who perform, play the instruments, right? That's normally who we're talking about. Then, see, in the Bahamian context, we include the fire dancer, the limbo dancer in arts and culture. Mm-hmm. We would include the quadrille, the straw market vendors in arts and culture. Creatives now is a new term that encapsulates a broader body of work, right? So a creative is now also a content creator, right? Before, when it was the days of ZNS and black and white TV, the content creator was creators were a team of people at NBC.
Right.
Who put together the shows and said, okay, these are the shows that we're doing. And then that's the director, the producer, and the actors. The content creator is like, they are the director, they are the producer, they're probably the star of their short film or documentary as well. They do the marketing.
Or
they
voice acting.
Right, voice acting. They narrate their own little piece. Content creator, right? So a creative may be, see those two gentlemen who be in town and they have a song for every event, like the two older boy them.
Yes. The Bohemian song.
Solo Made Them Uncle.
Yes.
Solo Made Uncle. Right. Those are creatives. Okay. Anytime an issue or solo made is a creative. Anytime a social or political issue arises, he creates art about it, around it, for it.
So this is why I asked Ms. Pratt, Tanisio, where do you come in? Are you a creative? What do you do to say that you're a creative? And particularly a Bohemian creative in terms of telling our story, our narrative? Because, you know, I'm big with stories, right, Aaron?
Yeah.
Oh, man. For me, I've always fumbled with the term creative because I felt like it was so broad. Like, anyone can be creative with anything.
Yeah.
You know? But if we were to discuss creative, and I think that for me as a poet, the creative aspect is definitely using social media to be able to grab attention or to grab marketing or do additional things along with my poetry. So this year, in February, I just was like, I wanted to create a daily series of reels where I talked about what self-love is. So each day I said something like, self-love is prayer. Self-love is cleaning the house. Self-love is going outside. So certain things like that in terms of content and being able to find creative ways to still bring the attention back to poetry and what I do.
Mm-hmm. How does an influencer differ from a creative or a content creator?
I feel as though, so I feel as though with influencer and content creator, they sort of run in the same lane, but I think influencer takes it to another level where an influencer is, they're often involved in brand partnership. Influencers are definitely focused on ways in which they can be able to, like you say, influence the people. And you don't necessarily have to have someone with a large following to be an influencer. You could be an influencer and have 500 followers. With content creators, I think that content creators focus more on the content, what they feel like producing, as opposed to what is this piece of content going to do for this person. So I think the main difference is an influencer is focused on content that they can create for people, and content creators can be that, but they're mostly people who create content for themselves.
Okay. All right. I think, Mr. Newry, we have, okay, let me put it to you, let me start again. This year, Mr. Brave Davis almost put himself on the list of creative influencers because of the commitment to creating a church, well, a school for the performing arts. It's, they've been speaking about it very broadly, but most important, the most important thing is it would range from like primary or junior school all the way to tertiary level, so open to adults. And maybe we can put him on the list for that. But the Bahamas, it's like we don't see the potential within us collectively and individually right now with the number of people who have access to a phone and the number of people who have access to consistent service. We have 300,000 filmmakers right here every day.
Yeah, definitely. I see the Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Youth, has produced or has commissioned a number of young movie creators.
Yeah.
As content creators.
And documentaries.
And documentaries, right? They have a series being shown on a various television shows now. And good quality work. I was very impressed with that. Just that, I guess we need outlet just for these people to do.
Yeah.
But I want to know, again, I ask... Tunisia, right? If, especially from a poet point of view, and I, especially I have you here, I'd be remiss not to ask, how can young poets, old poets, poets in general inside the Bahamas gain entry or find a venue that they can exploit their nice for their talents? Would you recommend for the person who have their poetry written down on loose leaf paper, but not just want to be published, but want to be heard, read, seen, right? How do they go from point A to point B?
I think that if you're at that point where you're ready to share, or you you at least want to be heard and try, I think the first outlet is always an open mic. An open mic is a good way. They're often hosted by bars or on or organizations, restaurants. If you can find a local open mic where you can be able to sign up and share your poetry, I think that would be an amazing start. I feel like when I started out specifically, I was so scared. I had my little notebook with all of my poems, and I was shaking. But when you get off that stage, you walk away feeling accomplished, even though you might have been afraid, and you feel the desire to go back again. So I definitely say, if you can't find one, start one. Galvanize people who are interested in poetry and listening to poetry, and share. Just share.
Do you know of any Facebook, social media group of that poets can
So I know of, well, I don't know of any online. I know that Poinciana Paper Press by Sonia Farmer, she created an online community called NapoRemo. So that was created during the National Poetry Writing Month, which was earlier this year. She has a writing community on WhatsApp where people share their work. So that's a good one. But otherwise, I know locally in Nassau, the open mics that I can remember on the top of my head is KLC Entertainment. They have a open mic that's at the Studio Cafe. And Michelle Hanna also does an open mic at Traveler's Rest and I believe Studio Cafe as well.
Consistently for what, 20 years? Michelle Hanna has been creating a space for poets and spoken word poetry for easily 2 decades, man. Easily.
Consistently, nonstop.
I see we have a caller here and then we have some live read. I want Aaron to read. So let's go to the caller there. Okay. Go ahead, caller. Can you hear me?
A pleasant good morning, Mr. Newry and Ms. Green, and to your lovely guest.
Hey, that's right.
I'd like to congratulate. She sounds so young from this end.
She looks young.
Yeah, but you know you in there. You could try and make that woman feel good, even if she was old. But anyway, that's your job. Congratulating, young lady. You sound very, very intelligent. Very, I would say that with the advent of open talk shows and with the advent of smart cellular phones, because Ms. Green, you know, I always tell you history. I was with Batelco when it first came in, when Peoples came in. Mm-hmm. That was the first communication we had other than the landline phone. Mm-hmm. And then cellular came in with Motorola. Hello, Moto. And then Nokia. But at that time, we couldn't text it. We only could call from phone to phone. Then Samsung came in with the smartphone, then the BlackBerry, then they came in. You know, all that type of stuff. I was there through all the advents. And you people as well, Mr. Newry and Ms. Green, y'all are motivators as well with the talk shows. And one problem I have sometimes is when talk shows, new talk shows hosts come in, they first start off by begging everybody to call them. And then they pick out the special people that they like to call them and shut down the rest. And, you know, I think everybody has a listening ear. Everybody has a way of opening up. You got those that talk, those that listen, those that text. They said listen to everybody because we are opening up our culture now. We're starting to speak. We're starting to write. We're starting to bring the Bahamian people out to the light. And I can tell you something, Mr. Newry. You know, don't get me wrong in this statement. The other day, Mr. Newry, you made a lot of people laugh. A lot of people came up. Why did Mr. Newry do that to you, Sparky? I say, I have no idea. They say, Sparky, as long as you've been around here trying to get property, you get property now, and Mr. Newry try to shut you down, but they must take your property back and give it to somebody. That's we always match with one another. Mm-hmm. Instead of building up one another, we pull one another down. I am trying to start a farm, and you trying to tell the government take the property back from me.
Yes.
That, I did not like that, Mr. Newry. Have a good day.
Thanks. Government, if you hear me, if Sparky ain't farming on that farm, take it away. I just had to repeat it just to make sure he make sure didn't think I stutter. Just making sure he understands. If he ain't working it, take the farm away. Okay, we can continue though.
Good morning, Mr. Newry. Thank you. Thank you. So, you know, I don't know if you guys remember when there was a Bahamas writing workshop series co-organized by Helen Klinaris. The collective had a formal name. I just can't remember the formal name at this time. But it was going strong for maybe a whole decade, where they would have a Bahamas Writing Institute. That's what it was called. And they did a number of years of programming where they attempted to support local writers through a community resources and share their work. We definitely need more of that. Oh, Mr. Newry, we have a giveaway. Mm-hmm. So here's what we could do. Producer, prep us for a break. Let me do this live read, and we're going to go to the break. And when we get back from the break, you're going to have your trivia question ready for the day?
Yeah, ma'am.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Here we go. Again, another live read from John Bull. Elevate your festive season at John Bull's Boutiques at Bahama Holiday Event this Friday, December 15th at 6 p.m. Enjoy exclusive and immersive experiences from world-class brands steeped in grandeur and extravagance. John Bull invites you to the ultimate festive soiree at their boutiques at Bahama Joy Event. Immerse yourself in exclusive experiences from world-class brands including Rolex, Cartier, Breitling, Bulgaria, David Yurman, Mac, Tory Burch, Tiffany & Co., and more. Enjoy family-friendly events. events, entertainment, seasonal snapshots, giveaways, perfume personalization, caricatures, curated Mary must-haves, signature cocktails, light bites, and more. Thank you. So let's go to a break. When we get back from the break, you're gonna start your Junkanoo jingle to Bay 5K trivia.
Yeah, man. I have a question already.
We have one more race packet to give away. If you play the trivia, you're expected.
You think Dwight can let me keep that? This no.
No,
you. I always wanted a Santa suit, though.
Are you gonna race?
I could be still working.
No, the package is for people who are going to do the race.
So whoever calls need to say they're going to do the race.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And don't, listen, don't send two-pot cake in the Santa Claus suit like a, you know, in the little trench coat you're in a trench coat, try to walk into the adult movie.
Yeah.
Don't send your two-pot cakes in your Santa suit to do the walk for you, please.
Yeah, I'm good.
Good stuff. Producer, let's go to a break. When we get back from the break, remember the numbers to call, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259, 242-300-5720, text line 422-GR96, that's 422-4796. We'll be right back.
Every day, countless Bahamians fall asleep hungry. But by working together, we can change this.
AML has committed $20,000 to provide nutritious meals for those in need during the holiday season.
As the holidays approach, help spread love and hope by supporting AML's 8th annual Feed 5,000 program.
Donate Fresh Market, Crossright, Exuma Market, and Domino's Pizza.
Bueller gal, can you believe this? We are now the patrol queens of the neighborhood.
We now large and in charge. So we need to check out what's going on in everybody yard. What about that gun that we know that Junior and his homeboys just ran out? Can we report that too?
Of course we can.
But we could be in deep trouble if they find out.
We need to report what we see, Bueller. When you call Crime Stoppers, they just answer your call in Miami.
So then we can report everything? Guns? Where they hiding the drugs? Who shoot who? Who part of which gang? Or who disturbing the peace with the loud music and the motorcycles?
Then our neighborhood will be the best in the Bahamas, and everybody gonna want to come live here. And then our house price will go up, gal.
So what we waiting on? What's the number?
If you see something, say something. Let us all pitch in and stop the crime before it's your time. Call 328-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands, or text us through the Crack Crime Bahamas app. Stop the crime before it's your time.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call 26717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Merry Christmas. Come be told me, ba-da-ba-ba-ba. A newborn king to see, ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I have yet to hear this version. This is nice. Is it Bahamian?
I'm asking, is it Bahamian?
No, it's not Bahamian.
It is.
It's
yes.
Bahamian? This is nice.
You think they'll switch this out for the Mariah Carey?
They better. In the Bahamas, it's now against the law to play. We don't single out Mariah, because Mariah is, I think she's our friend. But we're just saying, Mariah, it ain't you. It's the law. The law says we could only play this version and other Bahamian
but
versions
that
for
was
Christmas.
Nice.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, that's why I wanted to do this show, right? Because we got it, you know. We got the talent.
We have quality creatives, though.
We have.
People are so naturally talented.
Yes.
Like, they could just point a camera in front of them and just make it funny. Make anything creative.
I'm telling you. You see the by them Conk Boy Productions? Is it Conk
yes.
Boy?
Mm-hmm.
They bad from movies to short films to music videos mm-hmm. to commercials. They just, and you know, they you know what I find? Government have the best PSAs. Mm-hmm. The Office of the Prime Minister, mm-hmm. whoever making their footage, whoever's doing their campaigns, mm-hmm. they are world class.
Yeah, his team is amazing.
Nice.
Yeah.
You spend that money. Get that money.
When you got the best Bahamian talent, mm-hmm. right? See, like, we not, Bahamians not upset at you spending the money, right? But there's some factors that have to be balanced. Mm. And we want to ensure that you not just finding the best Bahamian talent, but you create a field where the best talent can rise to the table.
But I want to do my giveaway. I want to do my giveaway. Then I was going to ask Ms. Pratt, Tanisha Pratt, about the orange economy. Is it a real thing? Can we make money off of that? Or this is just idle talk? Because they've been talking about this orange economy for decades now. It's a buzzword. Oh, the orange economy. The government saying the orange economy. The artists saying the orange economy. And then it just seems to be a lot of talk. But this is my question for the day. First person to call, first person to text. I really want someone who actually is going to make sure and participate in this fun walk, right?
It is for someone who is going to partake in the run.
Yes. And my question is about Rudolph itself. Rudolph went to reindeer school. Inside the song, inside the movie, Rudolph.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Let them know, because I know a Rudolph. I know he been to reindeer school.
This Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer went to reindeer school, and he took a number of subjects, right? And he got A in a number of these subjects, but he failed one. I want to know, which subject did Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer failed? It's an easy question.
Because the other Rudolph, you know, he failed post office class. I know he failed that class.
You go back to the song says it. If you go to the movie says it. It says definitely that Rudolph failed a particular subject and he passed all the rest. So we had first person to call in.
And tell us which subject did Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer, fail in reindeer school?
Yes.
Numbers to call, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259, 242-300-5720. Text line powered by BTC, 422-GR96, that's 422-4796. Ms. Pratt, when you was young, what did you want to be when you grew up?
I wanted to be an ice skater.
Look, I wanted to be an astronaut. Look at us. Like, just
night and day.
Born in the wrong... Born in the wrong time zone, born in the wrong hemisphere.
An astronaut and an ice skater.
Yeah.
I wanted to be many things. I couldn't make a decision.
Yeah. What you wanted to be when you...
Me?
Yeah.
Up until grade 12, be Spider-Man.
What?
Up until grade 12.
Until grade 12?
You know when spiders bite me? And nothing. Absolutely nothing.
You might be on to something.
When I realized I wasn't going to be an astronaut, I decided I wanted to be a reader at ZNS. And I've been working on that voice. It's not working out well. But I've been working on the voice.
It's a specific voice.
It's a very specific voice.
I know the general manager at ZNS now.
You do?
Yeah, I mean, I can call
you think
it.
You could put a song in for me?
Yeah, say a word.
No, I need a whole need a whole song.
But I like songs.
That's why I'm going to need a whole song.
But you can't sing.
I didn't say I can sing. That's why I need you to put the song in for me, sir.
You got to lay that record down.
Yeah. We have another caller here, though. Let's go to the caller. Go ahead, caller. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Hello.
Good morning, ma'am.
Fail history.
There you go.
Look at you.
Now, ma'am, you participating in this race, right? Ma'am?
You answered the question and gone.
Ma'am, you can't hang up the phone. Are you? Boy, look at
the lady. She answered the question and gone.
So is she not going to do a run?
Ma'am, we're going to need you to call back in the next 3 seconds, or we're going to need to find another question.
Yeah, man, you need to secure your gift and the participation in the fun walk. Yeah, we call it back. But yes, Rudolph went down in history.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The song say that.
Yeah, the song says that.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Rudolph, he did well in flight school.
Take it.
My producer say that does not qualify. I love you, producer, but you just get it.
Kermit's slow. Look at him. He's on the ground laughing, man.
You fail that class too? Yeah. But I fail it too. I'm not upset about that. Yeah. Okay.
Yes, he's going down in history. Yes. You'll go down in his story. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Is that a dad joke? Well, doesn't feel like trivia.
I like history. It's a good question, man.
And Bahamians are natural comedians, Miss Newry, but you got to find another question.
Yes, I shall find another one.
And you got to find another question quickly. It's 11:35. We're going to get another question up there. The text here says physical education. No, he didn't fail. I don't think he failed physical
Did we find who was Santa Claus? I mean, St. Nicholas Arterial?
Yeah.
Oh, did they answer it?
I got that. Text?
Okay, good.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Okay, let's get back to the list of influencers nominated for 2020. We're nominating for 2023. I got a text here that says, put Ianthea Ferguson on the list.
She's talented.
Mm-hmm. Please.
She is.
Definite content creator, and maybe this could give us another sense of what a content creator is. Mm-hmm. Ianthea has created her career. She creates her income streams, right? And she uses her real, authentic daily experience to inform and build her content. That's a big part of it as well. Other people, content creators, use their daily experience to build their content. I also want to throw Jay on the table. Jay is a former Guardian as well, eh? Mm-hmm. Podcaster, doing big things. Jay is Shar Hansen from Boost Academy's husband.
Ah.
Yeah, yeah. I want to say Jay Mitchell.
Phoenix.
Phoenix, right. Jay Phoenix. There we go. Okay. Also on the list, again, I said Muffin Fernanda. Christina Fernanda from One Family has to be on the Creative of the Year 2023. Remember, under her leadership, and I have to say this, they have a different leadership style, right? So they have more of an egalitarian, but she is the formal head of the body. Under her leadership, they won two back-to-back. One Family came out and took two back-to-back. And the strategy.
The strategy.
The strategy. They prepare for New Year's first. And then they prepare.
That's smart.
Right, when they finish their New Year's prep, then they do Boxing Day.
That's smart.
Yeah.
I have another trivia question. Hopefully this person will call in. Quick, 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 what did
he say? He said, don't let the cat out the bag.
Okay. No,
No, they say that on air. They say that on air.
So this is for the Santa Claus suit.
Yeah.
And for
the registration package.
Registration package.
To participate in the Junkanoo Jingles of Bay 5K.
You don't have to pay. Once you win this, you don't have to pay to enter the competition.
Yeah, but you have to enter the competition.
But you have to enter the competition, right?
Yeah.
So how much is this package worth?
This package is worth $45
in
registration packet, and it's priceless in terms of what you get to give back.
All the pictures and everything, right? I want to know who is Rudolph's father. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a father, right? He had a daddy, and a good daddy too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Of Rudolph's father.
What is the name of Rudolph the Reindeer?
Yeah, father.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer's father.
They get blanket CDs, people, like Christmas question. Nice. Next week, when we do our trivia thing.
Long Christmas questions.
All kind of gifts.
I got two callers, producer. Let's go to that first call. Good morning, caller.
Good morning, Erin. Good morning, Mr. Newry.
Morning.
It's Dasha.
No. It's not Dasha.
Okay.
Wow. Okay.
Thank you.
What's cousin going to go in that race, though? She thinks she's going to walk. No, she's just going to walk.
She'll go again, the race is, the trivia is for people who intend on participating in the Junkanoo Jingle to Bay 5K this Saturday, 16th of December.
Everybody hang up then. Look how you run these people. The people won their Santa Claus suit.
Okay, I have an answer via text. The texter says Donna.
Donna is the name of Rudolph's father. He had one of those unisex names. It freaked me out
Donna
when I was younger.
No, Donna is D-O-N-N-E-R, not D-O-N-N-A.
Oh, it's D-O-N-N-A. Donna.
I thought it was E-R. Okay.
No, it's not
okay,
Donna.
So
it's not Donna.
I don't have a problem with it.
It's Donna.
I don't have a problem with it. But how do you know that Donna is Rudolph's daddy?
Because on the movie, they said Donna and his wife had Rudolph. And he was in charge of the slave and talking to Santa Claus saying, my son is ready. And then Rudolph took off flight. And then his nose cover came off. Donna.
So listen, this is a Bahamian story. Besides, it was a Bahamian story because this is a story of nepotism. Mm-hmm. This is a story of structural oppression. This is a story of rising beyond, you know, the most obstructive obstructions.
And we need content creators who can create Bahamian stories based on Christmas, based on reindeers,
based on Chicharnies, you know, based on Bohemian, what do you call it, fairy tales. We just need people to create content and then sell that.
But you Absolutely. Know who is an influential content creator that's dealing with history? Sasha Wells. So she is Baha Reads. Baha mm-hmm. Reads on Instagram mostly.
Yeah.
And she features a lot of books that she is reading. So she's an influencer in what she's reading. She also is a PhD student in history. And her content is really, really, really good and consistent. Another one is Bodine Victoria. Now, she doesn't deal in history, but you know Bodine. She's a singer. She's multifaceted, but she also has a really good, influential channel.
Now, let's talk about it. What you highlighting her for? Is it for the work around food and preservation of traditional Bohemian recipes? Is it
now that's a good one.
Her music and artistry, or is it the way in which she has been creating models and modules for teachers to support teachers sort of in an administrative space? Like, she is building tools for local teachers.
That's a good question. I feel like she should be nominated for all. But personally, me, what I enjoy is the food. I here for the food. And I here for the music.
Yeah, absolutely. I get to throw Shine 242 on the list as well. Shine had I don't think he entered his song in the Jubilee Song Competition, but he had a song that he released for Independence that should have been in the Independence Song Competition, definitely. He's been making music all this year. I mentioned Valine Roll and Shad Fur as a part of Impro Vibes, the comedy troupe, and being a part of the new TV show Justice with Judge Carroll. But Shadfer and Valine are also music artists. Valine goes by Vividly Val.
Very talented.
She put out a ton of music this year.
She could sing.
Really great stuff. I got to put a young woman by the name of Camila Gibson on the list for 2023. And I can tell you why. Camila's been making music for a hot minute now. She's based in New York, well, in the States. The last part of this year, touring with No Name. Do you know the rap artist No Name?
Yes.
She's been touring with No Name and was featured in a tiny, in an NPR
Tiny Desk
concert. I can throw my
pen on the drummer.
She's a pianist, but she's a singer.
Yes. Okay.
Primarily, but she can play her instruments, piano, guitar, soul, blues, jazzy. I just super talented. She's working on her own music. She let me hear a sneak peek. I was blown away. Even for old, I was blown away. And then she was featured with No Name on the NPR Tiny Desk concert.
She's doing her thing over there.
Pratt, is the orange economy possible to survive in the Bahamas? Or we just spinning our wheels and just talking about it.
I think it's possible. You know what I think the main barrier is for creators? Money. Finance, fundraising, capital to be able to be in a space where they can be able to create and have that peace of mind and space without having to focus on the stress of a 9-to-5 and a second job and a third job. It's, I feel as though if there's definitely more money or incentives allocated towards creative, we can make that happen. We have to start working on building these industries and making these opportunities.
So what do you recommend? And I assume that when I say recommend, it's for the government and also for private sector in terms of financing. But I hear you say money, but I don't know what you're spending my money on. So I don't. So I'm guarded with my money.
Pencils and paper.
They can do that themselves.
And film.
Okay, film kind of pricey.
Yeah. I mean, the real things. This is the one space where I think that we really need to re-examine the patron system, right? In the arts, in the cultural space, that's the one space where we should be encouraging patronage, right? In all the other spaces, we got to shut it down. But definitely here. People, Mr. Newry, remember when we go back to the classics and we think of the muse, right? And the role of the muse. The muse was just an inspiration. That's all the muse did. The muse is just an inspiration. They don't have to do nothing else but be, right? And in the same way, the artist that draws from the muse, the only thing they need to do is create art. That's it. They shouldn't have to worry about anything else. But in those spaces, art and culture were an essential part of your social development and your national development. So essential that when you go into the judicial community, when you go into the legal community, the extent to which Shakespeare's works are a part of jurisprudence and legal discourse, right? You'd be surprised. Why is it now in the 21st century we think differently? We think there's no space for that, right? In those spaces. Something's just been flipped on its head. But you better go on, because I got a list of names I won't call off.
You can continue the names. I want someone win the...
You're absolutely right. Let's repeat. I've got two texts here, and I just check in the texters to make sure they're going to participate.
Okay, checking. Okay.
Because a lot of Bahamians just won't be right. Right? They just won't be. And I get that. It's a fun trivia. That's a fun trivia question as well. But the trivia today is... for people who are going to participate in the Junkanoo Jingle to Bay 5K Fun Run Walk this Saturday, December 16th, 6 a.m., leaving from Arawaki, going to the Rubus on East Bay by Commonwealth Bank, and then returning to Arawaki.
I guess my next question is, if anyone have Bay Street Junkanoo tickets for sale, can you call the studio? No, that's not a good question.
I mean, that's not a good trivia question. That's an excellent question.
I mean, they could call because I need some tickets.
That's an excellent question because people can't find tickets.
The number is 323-6232.
I just want to say this out loud since obviously this is my Grinch week. Mm-hmm. The people are having great difficulty buying tickets on the website. Mm. Some people are having difficulty buying tickets on the website.
The website has issues.
Again.
Okay. The Grinch lived. I guess that's a question. And that this person will win this $45 package to get the Santa suit. They have to be able to participate in this fun walk thing that's going to be happening on which day?
Saturday, this Saturday, December 16th at 6 a.m.
6 a.m. And they're walking from?
You're walking from Arawaki along Bay Street to the Rubus near Commonwealth Bank on East Bay Street. Then you can turn around and walk back.
And the majority of people be wearing what?
Santa Claus suit.
So imagine 6 o'clock in the morning, we have... white, black, Asian Santa Clauses walking up and down and singing Christmas hymns and carols and having a merry time.
Absolutely.
You bring your camera out.
And I hope a cruise ship is coming in. I hope a cruise ship is coming in Saturday morning so they could see a parade of red Santas moving up Bay Street and get excited and have to come off the boat to figure out what's happening.
Long Island red Santas?
Any kind of red Santas. I don't care.
I like Long Island red Santas.
I love them too.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go to the caller there. Go ahead, caller. Can you hear me? Go ahead, caller.
Hi, a pleasant good morning to you both. How y'all doing?
Good, thank you. How you doing?
Okay, Aaron, I'm just joining in just for transparency. Mm-hmm. But you were saying something about tickets are difficult. Which tickets are difficult to access?
I'm saying that a number of people have indicated that they're having difficulty purchasing Junkanoo tickets on the website.
You know, I'm happy you brought that up, Aaron, because from I heard in the news, mm-hmm. Which is where I normally get my news, mm-hmm. A red flag was raised immediately in my mind. Well, you all were saying in the news that before the tickets were even bought online for sale, they were predominantly sold out, right?
No, that's not what was said. What was reported was that people attempting to purchase tickets indicated that they attempted to purchase tickets as soon as the portal opened. Mm. And the portal itself indicated that a major proportion of the tickets that people were seeking were sold out. Or unavailable. Right. Sorry, the language is unavailable.
And I think Alive addressed that. They said they had issues with their system, and they gave an alternative system to go and use.
Right. Then they also indicated that 34% to 40% of tickets are earmarked for particular people, and that may have been why people were seeing seating areas marked as unavailable on the site.
Aaron, let me tell you. From the news that I heard on The Guardian, mm-hmm. I didn't catch Alive's announcement that, but from the news that I heard on The Guardian, mm-hmm. it was said that before the tickets, unlike times past, because there's always a blocking out of tickets for a certain segment of persons, sponsors, participants in the Jungle Noon Parade, their immediate family. So there's always been that blocking out of tickets for them, Aaron. But there's But there's never been an issue, even with that blocking out.
Oh, there's been an issue. There's been an issue.
Well, Aaron, let me put it to you this way. I'm an avid supporter of Jungle Noon, right? Mm-hmm. My entire life.
Mm-hmm.
And there's never been an issue in my experience.
Anton, you want me to put you on my list for most creative influencer of the year? I mean, I can leave off the influencer part and just leave the most creative person of 2023. That's what you want to do?
Yeah, but let me just make this one little point here.
Okay.
I've never seen well in any of my years of purchasing Jungle Noon tickets. And I've always purchased tickets in the Rawson Square area. Scotiabank, Rawson Square area. Mm-hmm. Because at one point, Scotiabank was even hotter than Rawson Square. They are saying this year, more so than last year and any other year, based on what I heard on The Guardian, that there were less tickets available when those tickets went live for sale online. Pairs of seating or triplets or quadruplets of seating in the high demand areas from Scotiabank North and South to Rawson Square North and South. And so that raised a serious concern for me and a red flag. What is happening behind the scene or what has happened behind the scene? Why it appears that less tickets were available this time around than they were all the previous years past? Mm-hmm. Because if it is what I'm thinking, that is an even bigger concern that needs to be aired out, because it would be unfair to the public who's looking to participate in ticket sales if these tickets are even being sold out before they're even allowed to come online for public sale. Mm-hmm. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Absolutely, Anton. Thank you very much for the contribution. There has to be equality and equity. I want to say this. If you work for government, right, you got a good job. That's what I mean when I say you got a good job. They can't just fire you. Mm. You got a good job. You can't just get fired. In fact, I don't know if you could even fire a public servant. I think it's impossible. I don't think it's possible in law, in the universe, to fire a government employee. You got a good job. Once you were permanent and pensionable, you good. When you work for government, you get plenty perks. First perk is you get to say, I work for government.
Aaron, look like nobody won win this.
What more perks you want?
What about the Santa suit? We can take, can I keep it though?
Okay, the Texas say.
But I won't keep it though.
Listen, the person who won the prize said just now, I walked too long during slavery day in Fox Hill.
Oh my God.
I understand. I understand.
I get it.
I saw flashbacks.
Absolutely. Let's try one more time.
Yes.
You get.
But before we try one more time, I want to have Tanisha Pratt remind us about her event, and then we could move this prize forward. No.
To tomorrow, hey?
Tomorrow is another day.
Yeah, we could do that.
When is the event Saturday? Yeah, we could
do
it tomorrow.
The event is Saturday.
Yeah.
Because I have a trivia question, but we only have a few minutes. Let's go.
Yeah. So you, go ahead, Tanisha Pratt.
Let us talk about Winter Blues, a poetic musical experience.
Yes. So Winter Blues is inspired by my book, Blue. It is going to be a live jazz and blues fusion with storytelling and spoken words. So it's going to be very theatrical. It's going to be very musical. Alongside me, I also have other acts that are going to be on. The poet Andrew Gomez, the music and song, the singer and songwriter Navarro Newton, Kezia Noriega, and the jazz band, the Central Drive Collective, is going to be hosted by Princess Pratt.
Another nominee on our list for this year.
Yes, we're also going to nominate Princess Pratt as the Bahamian folklorist and griot. Mm-hmm. So Princess Pratt is
you related to Princess Pratt? Because you all have the same last name.
I feel like we are.
Okay.
We are. Yeah. We are. Okay. I feel like all the Pratt's related in one way or another.
All right.
So the event is going to be this Saturday as well, but it's going to be from 7 to 10 p.m. So the tickets are $30 general, $60 VIP. And the general comes with a complimentary drink, thanks to Liquorland.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Again, Saturday, December the 16th, 7 to 10 p.m.
7 to 10.
Fiona's Amphitheater, National Art Gallery of the Bahamas. Don't be afraid if it's raining. They are able to transition the event inside the gallery, so mm-hmm. you'll be safe parking.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, so parking is definitely going to be organized by the NAGB. There's parking that should be across from the building and by Jordan.
Excellent. Mountains. Parking is taken care of. Mm-hmm. All right, as we go towards the end of the show, mm-hmm. top creative story, top story of the year in the arts, culture, and creative space.
Top story of the year.
Yeah, top story. It don't have to be scandal. It don't have to be political, that kind of thing. Just top story of the year.
I don't know. I think for me, it's definitely the top story is just being able to see the buzz around the Bahamian citizenship test. That to me, that was a top story. Being awesome. Able to start from scratch, galvanize Bahamians from all different parts of the world, and being able to get the attention of the Prime Minister. I love that.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Mr. Newry?
Well, I love the idea that Shakespeare in Paradise had a show, 50 mm-hmm. shows.
They had a year of theater.
That was impressive.
That's a great story. Impressive. Maybe my top story of the year is Patrice Francis and Dion Johnson exchange and work with the London Shakespeare... What's the proper word, like authoratory or something like that? But Patrice Francis and Dion Johnson were both selected from the Bahamas to perform in Shakespeare classics at the premiere, on premiere stages in England, I think this year. Patrice first and then Dion went down in the second cohort. Mm-hmm. I think that's a major, major story to be covered as well.
Yes, and even Fuse this year. Fuse, it was the art fair that happened at Bahamar.
Okay.
With The Current. So it included a lot of Caribbean and Bahamian visual artists in one space. I think that was one of the first times we saw all of the work by the different galleries around the country.
And Mr. Newry, the Ministry of Youth, Sports and Culture, Cultural Division, Culture Month, I think that's a great story. This year's Culture Month was jam-packed with
big
activity.
Big shout-out to the Ministry of Culture. They have done tremendous work this year. Tremendous work.
And the film festival.
Yes.
We have lots to celebrate in arts and culture. We have lots of resources available to us for our personal development and our national development. Mm-hmm. Mr. Nicia Pratt, thank you for joining us over
thank
the two shows. It was awesome. I had a great time. Mr. Newry, thanks for sitting in on my show, man.
Thanks for sitting in on my show, man.
Absolutely.
Yes, it's been Guardian Radio in the AM with C.A. Newry. Have a beautiful and wonderful day.
Yes, and
tomorrow we're giving away
the Junkanoo Jingle to Bay 5K registration packet.
So if you're interested in participating in that, call.
Call in for the trivia.
Call in for the trivia. And if you call me quick and say, man, Newry, I can definitely participate, I might work out vibe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also, if anyone is wondering where to get tickets for Winter Blues, you can definitely go to Liquorland. It's on Madeira and Patton Street.
Good.
There you go.
Got it right on AM.
Surprise.